Every day, historic buildings across America are being torn down, and what's inside can be lost or destroyed forever. But not if Mike and Robert get there first.
Bring it down just a little bit.
From an old farmhouse to an abandoned mill, together they restore, repurpose, or resell whatever salvage they can find.
Yeah, this is a little fun, but...
They're saving pieces of history and America one salvage job at a time.
The value just keeps going up.
They are the Salvage Dawgs.
What were you telling me about over at the warehouse?
Well, we got a bunch of these coming in, and I'm working on a way to store them. We won't have to... about 10 days... Uh-oh.
Yeah.
Oh, no. It's got something in the back of there. You know, this doesn't always end well. Let's go see.
You guys are going to love this.
No, we're not. I can tell right now we're not going to love it.
So I'm trying to build it up.
If you say we're going to love it, I mean, we're not going to love
it.
All
right. Well, let's see if that's true.
I kind of like it when he's bringing me surprises.
Yeah, well, this is certainly
Here, look at this one. We didn't have to pay for it. It's a consignment.
I love it.
A Robert smile.
All right, we're just leaving it at that. That's it. That's it. That's ugly.
That's right. That's right.
Is that the good side?
That's his best side.
That is his better side. That's right.
No.
All right. There's a local company that does props called 4D Studios.
Okay.
And this is foam. It's not.
Oh, God, he's ugly.
Look at him.
But what this is this was made in layers. This was sculpted in layers.
Wow.
Okay.
So styrofoam.
Yeah, and then they put it together and then put the coating on it.
That's pretty intense.
In layers. They would cut a layer out of a 3D.
Like a 3D printing?
Right,
yeah.
Basically.
Process?
Yeah. And then they'd stack it and then put it together. Isn't that cool?
Frankly, I think the whole process is a lot more interesting than the ugly result.
Well, you could get whatever you want, you know. You could get a Grace Kelly, yeah. a full-size Grace Kelly.
Mm.
You know how Robert likes Grace Kelly. So you can pretty much do anything you want. This is pretty
and
lame.
That's what they did with it? This technology and this is what they came up with?
Well, Robert, what would you do?
Not that. And then they went back to their parents' basement.
Another failed venture. Well, it's a different piece, and we're known for strange and unusual. Do I think anybody will buy it? You know, somebody that's into mythical creatures, you know, wants an unusual Halloween scary figurine to stick in the lawn. And
I can think of a couple people now that you put it
Yeah, see,
way.
There's a market for everything out there.
Yeah,
somebody will love that.
It truly is.
They will.
We've learned that.
That's what makes America
If I hate
beautiful.
It, they love it.
Now, is this a male or a female, would you
yes.
say?
It goes either way. Yes.
You don't want to play that game.
Okay, this week we got a half-day project up in Covington. This place was an old knee-high bottling plant in its day. Nowadays, it's the home of Steel Man Recycling, and they recycle e-waste. But inside, what we're looking for are the old factory doors.
Yep.
They're the wooden,
sliders.
Exposed tracks, sliders, and there's four of them. It's really the half-day job, so you, Grayson, and I are going to do it.
We's not
Y'all
me.
Are not part of the we. We only need three people to do it, so I think that's going to be fine.
While these guys are messing around with this easy job, I've got an idea for a bicycle gate.
Oh, nice.
Out of
what we got?
Antique iron and our very antique bike collection.
Nice.
So, seems like a pretty easy week for all of us, you know?
Okay.
I mean, you've scheduled, you know, you were in charge of scheduling this week, and it seems
always
like
it's pretty... I always take it easy. Hey, Ted's on my team. You guys got the hard stuff.
I'm considering going to Mexico.
All right, man, we're on a hunt.
I'm going to have to figure out if I've got any gates here to work with.
Yeah, well, we want
to... size the bike to the gate or the gate to the bike.
There are no brand new ideas, or the people that come up with those ideas, I'm not one of them. But, you know, I read, and I get ideas from magazines, and I saw this thing about a bike turned into a gate, and I'm like, man, we can sell that.
Do we still have the old jail gate? It was literally from a jail in Cairo.
Those right there.
Yeah.
Figured if I want to sell some of this iron that might not sell otherwise, I got to juice it up a little bit.
That's a great call. That's got our width for sure.
A lot of our customers are bike riders, so it's an edge, it's an angle to sell something. It's like, it has to do with what they're interested in, like a bike.
That's got a good look to it.
I like it, yeah.
I've got a bike collection out here, and they're not moving that fast either, so it's a good collaboration between the pieces.
Nah, this is art, not a bike. That's it, my friend.
Yeah, that's going to be good. Oh, I like it.
Heck yeah.
And this has already got a patina on it. I like the color match with the rust. You know, it's going to be a bicycle jailbreak.
Project Bicycle Jailbreak.
You know, builds are usually Mike's territory because I'm busy actually paying the bills. And Mike's out here coming up with the great ideas. But when I do have them, I'm like, okay, well, let's do that. Mine will sell. He'll enjoy his for years to come, but mine will sell.
Oh, what is this? What is this? I think Fred Sanford just pulled in. Hey, man, get this off my property.
Hey, don't scratch my truck.
Don't scratch my truck.
How you doing?
Hey. How are you, man?
Doing
good to see you.
Hey, Robert.
Great to see you, man.
My son, Warren.
Hi. Hey, Warren, Robert Cole.
Nice to meet you. Warren, how you doing, man?
Pretty all right.
Pretty all right. I like that. You know, you never know what's going to drive in the lot at Black Dog. And Pat, one of the local pickers that we buy from, rolled up with his son in a truck full of some cool stuff. I'm coming to see.
I love that truck stacked up when he comes in
it
there.
It did. He had almost the exact look of Sanford's sons. Yeah.
This is somebody's Mother's Day gift. It's an Ideal horse machine.
Yeah, that's one of them washers.
That's a beer cooler is what that is.
Those wash basins were to wash clothes in, probably from the 1930s or 40s. It doesn't have any use for its original purpose, but you see it at somebody's backyard for a party, and you see it filled with cold drinks, you know, sodas, of course. But that's what it's for.
This is kind of cool. This is an Amish bench.
Amish bench.
It's for fixing harnesses.
So it has a strap that comes through here and the treadle.
Is he acting like he knows what he's talking about here?
Are you Amish, Mike?
Oh, well, me and Vanilla Ice.
How much time have you spent in
Pennsylvania?
Vanilla Ice Tea. So I was channeling my Amish. He just called me Vanilla Ice Tea. Does Amish.
Ah, there we go. Big Brave. That thing is not PC.
That's why we like it.
I love it. You like it, yeah.
I'm a pinball machine aficionado, and even the parts to them, you can make great wall art, or you make tables out of them. And we didn't have to chop it up. That makes me feel better, because I hate chopping up pinball machines myself. Let somebody else do the chopping up, and I'll saw
that thing in a heartbeat.
He's relentless.
Get out of my way.
He's relentless, man.
I got no reverence for pinball.
Or much else.
Or much else. So what else we got here? We got a trunk.
Got a trunk.
Whoa. What is this? Hey, Robert. It's a jackalope.
It tastes like chicken.
The myth. The legend. It does exist. The jackalope is a fictitious animal that people have had fun with for years. It's a jackrabbit and an antelope. I think it's an abomination. That's going to go on the collection wall. It's just one of those keep pieces that, hey, mommy, what's that? Oh, turn your head away, son. That's a jackalope. What's the deal with the Republic sign?
Doesn't seem to want to talk about it too much.
Well, the sign is that it's kind of rare.
Well, he kind of, you know,
he don't see too many.
He's kind of in bad shape, too, Pat.
So was his truck.
Oh.
You know, I'm not feeling the love here, Warren.
I mean, Pat had a truckload of great stuff, but I don't have a truckload of money. So you have to make decisions. The same rule as in real estate. You make your money when you buy something. If you don't buy a piece of real estate at the right price, then you can't sell it and make a profit. That's exactly how any of this works.
Senator Byrd, apple crates, I'll be nice. $15 a piece.
Done.
Okay, the pinball machine top, $40.
Yeah.
You good with that? The Amish bench, $90.
Let's leave that out of the conversation.
Okay, all right.
Let's go 50 on the drums.
Yeah, okay.
Thank you.
You're welcome.
Pat's prices are reasonable and also spot on for a wholesale pick opportunity. And of course, everybody's got to make money. Got to make a buck, so he's going to mark it up, and that's what I expect. All right, the Republic sign.
How about 400?
How about six for everything?
Well, except for the sign.
No, I said everything.
I'm going to have to stick to my guns on the sign.
On the sign?
Yeah.
At 350?
Yeah.
Sounds like 950 for the bunch, I would say.
The whole thing.
Let's do it. Let's do the deal.
Now, are you collecting signs for yourself?
Maybe. You have to show me the sign.
Is that a loaded question? I mean, we like to barter, and that's trading stuff. And I knew Pat liked signs. And when Robert ran inside to grab the Bauer battery signs, Pat's eyes kind of opened up a little bit. He knew what it was.
Wow. That is sweet.
Well, it's got a little wear from it. They were stacked together, I think.
That's probably close to $400.
Right. What? $550.
Anytime I can pull off something where there's no cash changing hands, it works out great for everybody involved, typically, and that's what a trade's about. It's no different than having a cash transaction. It's just, this may work better for me, this may work better for you.
But you do $350 on it.
Would you do $9 on this?
No, I think we already did the deal on that.
Yeah, we'll do $350.
So $350 on that, so we knock $350 off the $950. Is that good?
Works for me.
All right. That's the kind of stuff I like. It's simple picking. Somebody we like, somebody we know, and he's got a good eye. So, yeah, we had a great time with him. We still friends?
Until the next round, we'll see. If you keep buying from me, we're going to be friends a long time.
Heading up to Covington today to salvage some old factory doors and an old knee-high bottling plant.
What's up, Covington?
This was a small salvage job. It was local. Didn't need to take the whole team. So I just took the best part of the team. Me, Ted, and Grayson.
Yeah, you got to take the appropriate tools. It's a three-tool truck.
We were tools.
Exactly.
Scalpel. All right, we're at the old knee-high bottling plant. It was bought by some people that are starting a recycling company. What they have in here is a couple of four doors that are the old warehouse-type doors on exposed rollers.
Yeah.
And that's what people like these days, like doing partitions and exposed hardware. Yeah. So we bought the rights to pull them out, and we'll take them back to Black Dog and
we'll sell them.
And do them. Yeah, they're easy. They're good to sell. Hey, who's here?
There's stuff going on in here.
Hi, how are you,
good
Mike?
To see you.
It's wonderful seeing you.
It's good being in Covington. Yeah, this is Grayson and Ted.
Nice to meet you.
Grayson. And Nicole Warren. So this is one of the doors that were, there's four doors here that we're going to get today. These were old warehouse doors, is that right?
The floor was this height.
It was up to here.
It was. Okay. And coming from the first building in through here with the production, they'd bring their sugars and that and bring them through these doors and throughout the building.
The folks who own this building, these doors were not functional anymore for them. And these doors turned out to be a little bigger than what anybody in a residence would use. But for us, doors are wood. They can be changed. I can change the size, height, width. It doesn't really matter.
Okay.
That
was easy, yeah.
So these were big doors. But with the hardware and just their look, they're marketable right away.
Here it goes.
Look how heavy it is, Mike.
You
should have thought of that before. All right, you put your end down. I got this. All right.
Okay. Well done, gentlemen.
There it is.
This is the real keeper of all the doors. I think this one will probably sell first. The cool part about this is the exposed track hardware, and they've clad it with a tin brick pattern on the other side, so when we turn around, it's going to look pretty cool. That's the money side right there.
Wow.
Somebody's going to love it.
Yes, clean it up. Don't change a thing.
Galvanized brick pattern.
Ooh,
that's cool.
Very cool.
Maybe shine it up just a little bit somehow.
Just wire brush it.
Wire brush it, yeah.
That's it. Put a clear coat on it.
All right.
Out the dough. These warehouse doors, we just leave them like they are because somebody might like them like that. We just knock the dirt off of them. Yeah, just the dirt. That's all. There it is, Ted. Oh, no! Did it get you in the head?
Beating up the drama.
Right over here against the wall. Ted, you all right?
Yeah. Accidents happen, but most of the time they're avoidable. But it's okay.
Spoken like a true safety officer.
Robert wanted to go with straight bars up and down on this, but after further consideration, I decided to change the design of the gate. Rather than looking like a bicycle that fell into a gate, we're going to cut all the bars out of the center of the gate, mount the bicycle, and then attach the bars to various points along the bicycle in order to give it a more aesthetic and creative design rather than straight bars. Very rarely I get on a project and follow it from A to Z and don't ever change direction. Usually I change direction two or three times along the way. But when your boss tells you to do something and you change it, you're putting the responsibility onto yourself. And they, like any boss, will let you know about it if it's not a good design. So now it's in my ballpark, and I need to make sure it turns out well.
I'm worried about getting that door out of that little entrance.
We'll have to get it off the track, walk it this way, and then all we got to do is get it a little bit of, just like that door in New York.
You guys have some experience.
Just a little bit there. So we moved on to the next door, the silver door from the elevator shaft. It was a little more difficult because we were in more of a confined space. We still had to figure out how to get it off the wall and get it off the tracks. We just couldn't lift it because it's really not meant to lift off the tracks because you don't want it coming off the tracks.
I'm seeing geometry issues.
All right, geometry issues.
I wish Tay was here to figure this out.
That's okay. You did okay in school.
Take a
watch. I passed with a C.
Knee high. So the dress was knee high.
Can you say knee high?
No. What are you drinking there? I'm going to have a bottle of no. No, it's knee high. All right. Let me see. I'll pull my hand out. This was definitely a job that was worthwhile. It didn't take us long, and these doors are remarkable because of the exposed hardware. That's what people look for these days, and that kind of industrial, lofty, warehousey look.
Also, they're all different, which is great. They got different patina, different paint, different whatever. But each one of them is going to sell, or is going to appeal to somebody. I think somebody in a studio or some sort of kind of warehouse, some sort of store, could easily use them.
And you can put it in your house, and it's real easy. So at least I think these will do.
I think we'll make money.
We'll do more than break even on these projects. Do more than break even.
Wow.
Zero. The floater.
All right, goodbye, Covington.
Have a good one.
See you again someday.
Hey, how are you?
Good. What you doing?
I'm just getting this last bolt tightened up on this gate.
Oh, my gosh. Look at this. So the bicycle's in the gate, not on the gate.
Yeah, the bicycle's part of the gate.
Oh, that's fabulous.
Robert wanted to go with straight bars up and down on this, but I thought it needed a little more pizzazz and a little more movement. So I decided to put a spoke theme going on at the top and a sunburst down here at the bottom to make it a little more interesting.
Well, Robert had a great idea. It was just the artsy fartsy part of it that was missing.
Utilitarian is what it was, for efficiency, for the bottom line.
Okay, I got that. But then now you have to make it appealing. You know, instead of looking like a bicycle that ran into a prison gate.
Which is really what I wanted it to look like, maybe even halfway through it. Maybe with a little oblique angle in it.
Well, it's a heavy-duty gate. It's hinged and latched, ready to go. You can put it in your garden.
Yeah, it would be a nice garden gate.
Make a great garden gate. Make a great bicycle shop gate.
Yeah.
What's really going to happen is somebody's going to go, I love that. It doesn't fit where I need. I need one very much like it at these dimensions. And it also doesn't have to be a bicycle. It's something to say, hey, that could be X. That could be what I do. Or, you know, we could put that in a gate. It just gives people ideas.
Great job, Peg. You just create wonders down there in that basement.
I'm glad you like it.
That was a good week.
Fantabulous week. I'm telling you what, I got to sit in my office most of it.
And do salvage. He did salvage from his office, which is no dirty hands, no cuts, no people to manage. Had a good pick with Pat, which is always fun. And then the build, you know. Hey,
had a project run wild on me.
That's pretty much the status quo, you know. You gave the inspiration. That was the inspiration.
I'm okay with it. I'm okay with it.
Yeah. Robert does not claim.
I'm not fronting over.
He does not claim the art part of it. Make it happen and show me the money.
That's right.
That's what Robert wants to say.
Bottom line.
Bottom line. He's a bottom line kind of guy.